Will lowering my PTH with calcium reverse my atherosclerosis? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Lauren, are you there?
I am.
Okay, cool. Hi, Lauren. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Good. So my question is, I had a CT scan for something like kidney stones, but they've had a different finding. And I was just curious about something related to it. The finding was that my abdominal aorta has mild atherosclerotic calcifications. And do you think that these would like go away as my PTH is suppressed? Right now, it's at the top, the absolute top of the reference range.
Right. I can only speculate, but what I can definitely tell you is that having your PTH at the top of the reference range will increase your bone resorption, which will enhance the risk of calcification. And so you will definitely be removing a major source of calcification risk if you suppress your PTH down into the bottom half of the reference range. And generally, I don't know exactly where the point of maximal suppression is, and I suspect it's different between different people. So what I would do is, however you're approaching that with vitamin D, calcium, et cetera, try something, remeasure it, try tweaking the dose upwards and see if it keeps going down and find the point of maximal suppression. And if you do that, it's hard to say where the difference is between not getting worse and reversing, but I think that will certainly, to the degree that you can reverse it, I think that would be definitely be an important thing to do in order to get reversal. And so I would hope so. And I think there's good reason to hope for that.
Okay, thanks. And we had worked together, you and I, and I have an action plan, and part of the action plan is to take 300 milligrams of calcium citrate with every meal. But I can't find something that's just calcium citrate in 300 milligrams. Do you happen to know of this?
I think you might be getting thrown off by the label, because a lot of times calcium supplements are labeled as the serving size, and the serving size is multiple capsules. So I'm just going to, as a crude way, just to take a look at what's available on Amazon. I'm just searching calcium citrate on Amazon now. And so just to pick, like one that comes up as a brand I recognize, Solaray, and it says calcium citrate, 1,000 milligrams. But if we look at the label, it's 4 veggie caps to get 1,000 milligrams. So the veggie caps are actually 250 milligrams per capsule. And then there's also powders on here, but let's see who else has. I think most calcium citrate supplements will come in capsules where the capsule itself is around 250 milligrams. And I think, what did I suggest? 300?
300, and I've been finding.
Okay, so I would just consider 250 good enough, and particularly because your diet is probably going to have at least 50 milligrams of calcium in a meal, and so that should get you approximately in that range. You might not find 300, but 250 is definitely easy enough to find. You'll probably find variations of that too.
Cool, that's awesome. Thank you.
You're welcome. All right. Take care, Lauren.
You too.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Masterpass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.